and welcome to Chemistry in Your Cupboard. I'm Rosie, an Education Coordinator for the Royal Society of Chemistry, and today I'm going to show you how to make rainbows with the red cabbage indicator, a simple experiment which you can do at home with a responsible adult. So let's get started.
You're going to need a red cabbage, some acids and alkalis that you can find in your kitchen, a piece of paper and a poly pocket and some paintbrushes, kitchen roll, and some cooking equipment.
Red cabbages contain anthocyanins. These change colour when they come into contact with an acid or an alkali. I'm going to use this today to make some rainbows. One made out of drops of indicator and one made out of homemade indicator paper. So let's start off with making the red cabbage indicator. Ask an adult to help you with this part. Take three leaves of the red cabbage and chop them up nice and small.
Put the chopped up red cabbage into a pan. Add enough water so the cabbage is just covered.
So boil the cabbage for about 10 minutes. Another way to make the indicator is by blending the leaves or leaving them to soak overnight. But if you boil the cabbage, then you can make indicator and have cabbage for your tea. So now that the red cabbage is cooled, I've put a couple of pieces of kitchen roll in the sieve and I'm going to drain the red cabbage through it to make the indicator paper. So can you see that the red cabbage has dyed the water purple? There we have our red cabbage indicator solution at the bottom, which is dark purple, and the cabbage is also drying the kitchen roll purple here at the top. So I've already drawn a rainbow onto a piece of paper and I've put it inside a poly pocket. What I'm going to do now is use a paintbrush to drop little bits of the red cabbage indicator onto my rainbow.
Now we're going to add some acid and alkalis that you can find in your kitchen to the red cabbage indicator to make some of the colours of the rainbow. First, let's try an acid. Here in this egg cup, I have some lemon juice. Pop a little bit onto your paintbrush and dab it into the first line of your rainbow. Look, as I add the lemon juice to the red cabbage indicator, it turns it from purple to pink. Now let's try an alkali. In this egg cup, I've got some water mixed with washing powder. I'm going to add a little bit to the paintbrush and dot it onto the red cabbage indicator. Cool, this time it's turning green. Let's try a different alkali. Now I've mixed some bicarbonate of soda with water and I'll put a little bit of that onto my paintbrush. Oh, this time it's turning blue. That's because my washing powder is more alkaline than the bicarbonate of soda. Here's my red cabbage rainbow. The red cabbage indicator is purple, the acids like lemon juice are pink, and the alkalis like washing powder and bicarbonate of soda are green and blue. It's super colourful, isn't it? Now that my homemade indicator paper is dry, I can paint a rainbow onto the paper using the acids and alkalis that I've found in my kitchen. I'm going to paint the first line of my rainbow with the acidic lemon juice. Look, as soon as the paintbrush touches the paper, it changes colour to pink. Now let's make the green line of the rainbow with the alkaline washing powder. Cool, that's instantly turning the paper green. For the final line of my rainbow, I'm going to use the alkaline bicarbonate of soda. Nice, that's changed the paper from purple to blue.
So here it is, here's my rainbow. Have a go at testing the acids and alkalis in your kitchen and show us your results using the hashtag #ChemistryInYourCupboard. So that was the red cabbage indicator experiment, which you can do at home with a responsible adult. We'll be back for more experiments soon, but in the meantime, subscribe to our YouTube channel for all the Chemistry in Your Cupboard episodes. See you soon!